Hi, welcome to the DevOps Lab. My name is Abel, and this episode we have a very special guest, Dipendra. How's it going?
Going great, thanks.
So what are we going to be talking about?
We're going to be talking about Azure DevOps Wiki. It's a documentation solution within Azure DevOps.
Awesome. Everybody, tune in. How's it going?
Going great, thank you.
Yeah. So what do you do at Microsoft?
I'm a UX designer with the Azure DevOps team.
Awesome. So I have a problem, right? As a developer, one of the things that I need to do is be able to collaborate with everybody else on my team. So I desperately need a system where I can store all that information. I need to be able to edit it easily. I need people to be able to access it easily, and also to be able to search. Now, what I heard is we've got this thing called Azure DevOps Wiki that can help me solve all of this.
That's right.
What is Azure DevOps Wiki?
Azure DevOps Wiki is a documentation solution within the Azure DevOps suite. It can help you address your documentation needs at various stages of your product development, be it creating specs, creating meeting reports, or just like any general information that you'd like to share with the team.
Very cool. So basically, yeah, I can create any type of documents that I need.
That's right.
Can you show us what this looks like?
Sure.
Okay.
So this is what Azure DevOps Wiki looks like. And since it's like part of the Azure DevOps suite, it's also well integrated with the rest of the services in the suite, be it like boards, be it repos. Also, Wiki is actually powered by an underlying Git repository, which also enables some of these really powerful workflows for developers.
Okay.
So let's create a new wiki. I'm going to demonstrate how do we create a new wiki.
Perfect.
So I'm going to head over to this project.
Okay.
And under the overview section, I'm going to click on wiki.
Okay.
As I do that, I land on this page.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to click on create project wiki for this demo.
Perfect.
Publish code as wiki is where you would go to if you're looking for some of the advanced Git capabilities. And we're going to cover that in another video.
All right.
So I go ahead, click on Create Project Wiki. We just created a page. I'm going to name this my first page, and I will save it.
All right.
Now, as I save it and close it, I land on this page. So here's like what your wiki looks like. You know, here's the name of your wiki, and here's this hierarchical tree view wherein you can see a listing of all your pages, and there's the page right there.
Perfect.
So I'm going to demonstrate some of the more capabilities of Wiki, and let's create a new page.
Sure.
All right. So
you just created a new page.
I just created a new page by clicking on plus new page. I'm going to name this meeting notes.
Okay. So this is a wiki, or I guess the wikis are Markdown, correct?
That's right. Wiki is actually powered by the Markdown.
So this is a Markdown editor built into Azure DevOps.
That's right. Absolutely.
Sweet. All right. Yeah. Let's see some more cool stuff.
So there's like a formatting toolbar right there on the top. And this is for like users like me who are not very great with the Markdown syntaxes.
Perfect. Like me as well.
Yeah. And there's also like a link out there which says Markdown supported.
Okay.
So in case if you're looking for more Markdown syntaxes, you just click there and then it takes you to all this list of supported Markdown syntaxes.
Very cool.
So that comes in pretty handy.
Okay.
So let's start typing in.
Okay.
So since we're taking meeting notes, let's type in the agenda of the meeting. And so as you can see, as in typing in, there's a real-time side-by-side preview. And whatever I type in actually gets rendered on the right. And so,
nice.
So that way I get a preview. In case if I want like just a preview only mode, you can also do that by toggling it here.
Okay.
So let's see if we can format this content.
Sure.
So I just select the string, and I'm going to make this a header one style. Notice what we did here is that we actually added the hash, which is the Markdown syntax for creating H1 styles. So there's that. Next up, I am going to create a table of contents.
Okay.
So I head over to these ellipses, click on table of contents. And as I do that, it just automatically generates a table of contents, which gets updated with every new heading that I add.
Oh, very nice. I like this.
That's right. And Let's try creating some links.
Okay.
So I'm going to call this link to strategy.
Okay.
And so there are multiple ways of through which you can create a link. The first way is that you select the string, click on link here. Now at this point, I can actually insert a link which heads over to it, which is pointing to an external URL.
Mm-hmm.
Or perhaps I could even interlink some of the wiki pages.
Nice.
So I'm just going to enter in slash. Mm-hmm. And probably.
So you can enter in any type of link, right? External, internal, it doesn't matter. It's just a URL.
That's right, yeah.
Nice. So this is just basically a markdown editor. It's a kind mm-hmm. of a sweet markdown editor.
That's right, yep.
Nice. This should make editing these wikis much easier.
Sure. And there's also an option for me to actually drag and drop these links into the editor.
Nice.
Or perhaps, you know, if I want, I can just copy the page path and, you know, paste the link in there. So there are multiple ways through which you can actually paste in the link.
Very cool, very cool. What else can mm-hmm. we do with the editor?
Sure. Pasting images in wiki is fairly straightforward.
Okay.
I could simply have it on my clipboard and I could paste it in. So as you can just see, what happened is that it started rendering right here.
Mm-hmm.
Pasting images in Markdown can be kind of a complex process.
Mm-hmm.
But then we've really tried to make it super, super simple here. An alternate of pasting images would be to just click on this pin and then, you know, select the relevant image from mm-hmm. your PC and share.
I like that pasting thing so uh-huh. much, because that's always a pain when you're working with Markdown.
That's right.
Love it. All right.
Alternately, you could just drag and drop it in.
So sure.
Which is also pretty handy.
Nice, nice, mm-hmm. nice. So we're making just the whole editing the Markdown experience so much nicer and easier.
That's right.
Cool.
Yeah. Next up, I'm going to demonstrate how you can, a feature that comes in pretty handy while collaborating with some of my coworkers.
Mm-hmm.
So you can actually @mention some of your coworkers. What you need to do is to simply insert an @ mm-hmm. and you type in their name, pick it from the list, and simply insert it.
Very cool. So do they get notified if they're attached to, or not attached, but linked to a wiki?
That's right. The moment you tag someone mm-hmm. and @mention someone, mm-hmm. they actually get an email notification as well.
Nice.
So that's how it kind of works.
Okay.
Azure DevOps Wiki is well integrated with the rest of the Azure DevOps suite.
Mm-hmm.
And your documentation planning goes hand in hand.
Sure.
So you can also reference work items from Azure Boards into the Azure DevOps Wiki.
Okay.
So let me demonstrate that. I just select here, click on the hash over here, select the relevant work item I want to mention, and it starts appearing there.
Oh.
You can also see that there's actually the status of the work item that gets up here.
Uh-huh.
And as the status updates in Azure Boards, the same updates are also reflected right here in Wiki, eliminating the need of you having to manually update.
So all this info is live.
That's right.
Live data.
Yeah.
Very, very cool. Mm-hmm. And we can add work items directly into our wikis now.
That's right.
Sweet.
There is also some other sweet capabilities, like mm-hmm. being able to insert query results
mm-hmm.
and linking this page to other work items,
yeah.
which we will talk at length in another video, wherein we'll be covering Azure DevOps Wiki and Azure Boards specific scenarios.
Nice. So there's deep integration between our wikis mm-hmm. and the rest of the Azure DevOps suite.
That's right. Yeah.
Very nice. Is there anything else you wanted to show us?
Uh-huh. Sure. So I'm going to save this page and close this.
Okay.
Let me demonstrate another page wherein I have created some sample pages. So there's also support for rich
nice.
Content, like being able to create YAML tags
mm-hmm.
or embedding videos
mm-hmm.
and mathematical formulas.
Yeah.
If you want to create like more fancier looking pages, there's also mm-hmm. support for that. You can use embedded HTML and
nice.
Really get a control on the look and feel of the page.
Very, very cool.
So
we've now created just a very nice Markdown editor
mm-hmm.
that lets us create these super rich wikis super easily. That's pretty much it, right?
Right. Another thing that I'd really like to talk about here is the follow functionality.
Okay.
So it's really important for you to be able to track what updates are being made to certain documents
mm-hmm.
which are relevant to you,
mm-hmm.
and which is where the follow functionality comes in.
Okay.
So there's like this follow button right here.
Mm-hmm.
When I click it, I actually subscribe to email notifications
mm-hmm.
And any updates that the page receives, I am going to be notified on email about the update that just happened to the page.
Right. So you get notifications. Very, very nice. Mm-hmm. This is powerful, flexible, awesome stuff.
Right.
Yeah. All right. So you've shown us some amazing capabilities where we can create super rich wikis, right? But one of the things that I need desperately, not only is the ability to create these wikis, mm-hmm. I need to be able to search them. Right. So how can we search using Azure DevOps Wiki?
That's right. So being able to search and get to the right information is mm-hmm. really important in a team.
Sure.
And that's where the wiki search kicks in.
Okay.
It's powered by Elasticsearch, and anything that you type in to the Azure DevOps Wiki gets indexed. So as soon as I type in a string over here and search it, nice. I'm able to get right to it.
Okay. Very, very cool. Mm-hmm. That's also very popular. All right. This has been some amazing stuff that you've shown us. Now, not only do we have the capability of having wikis inside of Azure DevOps, but it seems like it's super easy to edit it, manage it, and search, correct?
That's right.
All right. So all you devs out there, go to dev.azure.com, create an Azure DevOps an account, and go ahead and start playing with the wikis and tell us what you love about it and what you hate about it so we can make Azure DevOps the ultimate DevOps tool. And everyone out there, thank you so much for joining us on this episode. And next time, we will see you as well.
Thank you.